Caroline, anybody who cares deeply about the young and ministering to the young wants to create space for people to train for, to be prepared for, to go into youth ministry. And if the space you happen to be working in is a seminary, then you are hoping that there are people who discern a call to youth ministry and then respond to that call faithfully, are equipped for it, and go act out that call. But as I watch the numbers of seminarians who really want to go into youth ministry or who really want to go into suburban youth ministry and discern and act on that call, we're not going to have enough people going into those fields to minister to them. We're going to have to look for people who experience a call in some other place and are prepared to act on it, because they went to train for social work and decided the best way to be a social worker is in a youth ministry context to youth. They went to education school and they decide the best way to teach is to be a minister to youth in a context of one sort or another. You went to education school and you ended up a youth minister. Help us understand what that felt like, how it happened, and what folks who think they're going to be teachers might look for as a cue that they're called to youth ministry.
Sure. This isn't a path that I necessarily would have known was mine in high school and even into college. But looking back, how could it have been any other way? And I think when we talk about vocation and when people feel deeply called to where they are working, that plan makes sense, read backwards. But we don't always have that luxury. And so where I think we need to go is, how do we speak openly and honestly with young people about vocation? Let's introduce that word, let's define it, and then let's start to explore it. Let's give them ways forward that they can see themselves in careers and places where their joy, where their passions can light up. Let's give them models for that. Let's recognize in them the gifts that we see. They're not always great at knowing what those are. It takes someone saying, I see this in you. I see this dotted line around you, and you're going to grow into it. I see the crown that you will wear and that you will grow into. But we can't always, as young people, and we can't expect of young people to see that in themselves, I think, all the time. That is a gift that we can give them. I think letting them try on lots of different hats and giving them lots of different experiences where they have agency, where we can show them opportunities that don't even exist in their context, whether it is too limited or too wide open, is a struggle that I see my young people having. And so a liberal arts education is wonderful, but it is so wide open. Well, let's pare it down for them. Let's recognize gifts and suggest things, but let's do it within a vocational call, and help them see that there are ways forward that they might not even imagine or know exist.